Hey everybody, Carl Schilling. I'm the founder and CEO of the Advocacy Network, and I wanted to speak to you today about something very, very important, I believe, for everybody, financial independence. Now, a while back, I wrote a book called The Middle Class Millionaire Plan. When we're done here, I'm going to give you a website where you can download the ebook for free. But in that design, what I wanted to clearly do is that for over 44 years, I've been in the financial services industry, sales training and development, and also spent a little time passing through the investor relations world. It was during that time, in the investor relations world, that I started my firm called the Advocacy Network, because I had seen so much financial victimization. So when I started the Advocacy Network, it was with one mindset. It was to inoculate and insulate people against all forms of financial victimization. Now, I think we've done a pretty good job, because to date, we just crossed the $15 million savings plateau for our members. So that's $15 million that would have gone directly to some form of a financial victimization. And I include scams, fraud, and predatory sales tactics as part of that. And believe me, a good majority of it is predatory sales tactics. So some of that is what I want to talk to you about today and show you briefly a little input into why financial independence is so important, but at the same time, so hard to obtain. And it's amazing. There's a 95-5 rule. Only 5% of everybody passing through our society over the last 150 years has ever become financially independent. Now, it's different things to different people. And the reason I wrote the book, when you read the book, Middle Class Millionaire Plan, it's talking to people in the middle class, people who feel like they have no opportunity to do the kind of things that we're talking about, the kind of planning we're talking about, but they do. And it wasn't just from a perspective of a public, of the public and a client, it was also from the perspective of an agent, a life insurance agent, because life insurance is the greatest financial tool that could ever be used for financial independence. But so few people know it, because so few agents are truly educated, and most companies are not educating the agents on some of the magnificent value propositions of life insurance. So let me share the screen here and show you briefly. As I mentioned, this is the book, The Middle Class Millionaire Plan, and you'll be able to reach out and get that book for free. Ebook, it's called, you go to www.theadvocacynet.com, theadvocacynet.com, and you'll see how to get that book, okay? So let me go to the other share that I want you to see that we'll discuss some of these principles, why we want to do what we're doing, okay? So let's take a look here. Firstly, I created several pieces to everything we do. The Middle Class Millionaire book, obviously, but also did a video course 4 or 5 years ago for financial literacy education, along with the power of having a financial concierge. That was called Financial Transformation. And that program, Financial Transformation, started out going for $595, $395. And I've added it now to the Advocacy Network membership. So in the Advocacy Network membership, you get the membership plus you get financial transformation. But I mentioned earlier about the 95-5, and I want to explain to you why. Imagine we're the richest nation in the world, and yet at the same time, we have the highest rate of financial illiteracy in the world. Now, why is that? Well, I believe it comes from conformity, the status quo, and a lack of vision. And that lack of vision is that, take the financial services industry. There's been so many myths that have been promulgated for the last 50 years, ever since ERISA, which was the for the qualified plans, we get into that with you on a consultation basis, but if you're in a qualified plan, we get a chance to really do a deep dive and show you just how dramatically damaged and how you're being financially victimized inside that qualified plan. And you are. You're being totally financially victimized. And it's been a myth that's been promulgated for about 50 years. So we go over that with you in a consultation if that's part of what you have in your asset base. Now, there's a lot of different reasons the normalcy bias exists for people. You see this a lot. Everybody, even in the period we're going through right now, you're going to see the irrational normalcy bias. We've gone through 2 years of a pandemic. And everyone has always relied on the fact that we're going to go right back to where we used to be, that everything is going to once again become normal. Well, that's not really true. We're going to be in a new normal, obviously. And a new normal means that people have to take on a new mindset. They have to make changes. Okay. Most people have a fear of change, and it's very difficult for them to shift their mindset. And that's the reason when I wrote the Middle Class Millionaire Plan, I wrote it to the public and I wrote it to agents, because an agent is a financial concierge and you as a client should have no gaps. There should be no gaps. You're both chasing the same thing. You want to be financially independent. Well, so does the financial concierge. So the two of you working together is like putting together a jigsaw puzzle. You need the pieces. But you also need to know how the pieces fit. That's where your financial concierge comes in. Obviously, a financial concierge is very, very up to date on many different things, and they can show you the true value proposition of how to build a plan to become financially independent. And that's the reason to have a financial concierge. Now, we also have social genetics where, you know, we've been socialized. So there's beliefs about money that every individual has, and you go through this in the book, in a Middle Class Millionaire Plan, to really ask some of these deeper questions. But why, you know, what do you believe to be true about money, and why do you believe that? And you'll find that most of it's social genetics. It's been passed down from family or possibly schooling, social networks, people around you. You have taken in all this information and you have driven your own confirmation bias. And that's what makes you very, very subject to poor advice, or mythical advice, as I like to call some of it. And then that leads to your financial behaviors. You know, you have definitely everyone has one. When you're going to make a purchasing decision, whatever that may be, anything, big ticket item, small ticket item, buying a candy bar at the grocery store, you're going to go through a process, a decision-making process, before you spend money. And that's going to always be the same because it's been locked in. So the typical scenario for everybody is we work, we earn, we spend, we then borrow to tap onto that, and then we pay. Okay. Well, I want to show people how to change and alter this just a little. So you work, you earn, you spend, you borrow, and you pay. And basically that leaves you in the situation you're in, which at the end of the month, you got more month than you have money. That's almost common for everybody. They say that very few people even have $400 in savings that could come up with that in case of emergency. So in financial transformation, which is a nice video course, none of the videos are longer than the longest video in is 9 minutes. I think the average on most of them is about 5 minutes. Okay. There's 8 modules and 8 lessons in each module. And they're all digital and interactive. You can watch them 24/7. You can watch them whenever you want to watch them. They're very quick. And you're going to learn the 3 golden rules for financial independence. It's going to be part of that. 3 types of income that's needed to become financially independent. And the 3 stages of you will be a big part of it too. The 3 stages of you are, you know, past you, present you, and future you. And we get to discuss how that plays economically, how that plays into your financial life. Okay, so that's money in 3D, past, present, and future. And then we go over interest. Obviously, the 2 things that can happen with interest. There's only 2 things that can happen with interest. You're either going to pay interest or you're going to earn interest. If you're going to become financially independent, you're going to want to earn interest, okay? So as I mentioned earlier, financial independence is like a jigsaw puzzle. It's a big jigsaw puzzle. And we want to build the frame from the outside. Most people, when they build a jigsaw puzzle, will build the square, the outside, and then fill in the inside. Now, unless someone's a savant, most people don't build from the inside out, but be very counterintuitive. So we basically help people build that jigsaw puzzle, bring all the pieces and how to create the pieces and then put them together. We want to help you with a contrarian mindset, how you can become contrarian, because that's really going to be the difference. That counterintuitive contrarian thought is going to be what's going to put you on the other side. Because if everyone's doing what everybody else is doing, that's why we got 95-5. So it doesn't make sense that everybody should keep doing the same things they're doing when we know that only 5% become financially independent. So what are the 5% going to do that the 95% won't do or don't know? They're unaware. They start at that stage of unawareness. They don't know what they don't know. They don't know that they don't know. And at some point they become aware there's something I don't know. And that's great. If they're willing to learn it, and that's what we're going to bring to you. If they're willing to learn it, they now have awareness. Awareness means they can now not just become familiar that there's something they didn't know, but they learn what they didn't know, and they actually can use what they didn't know. And that's going to drive right to financial independence. So change is really a constant. We're always changing. People who fear change don't realize that change is happening every moment of your life. Every breath you take, every inhale and exhale is a matter of change. That's a split second that's no longer available to you. There's a change. If you got up and you move from where you are now to go to someplace else, to sit down or wherever in the living room, that's a change. Everything's a change. Your environment shifts and changes. Your mindset shifts and changes. The way you take in information and the way you perceive that information changes. Everything changes. So if we look at the mythical model of the retirement industry, and this is not all about retirement, that's only one piece. If you want to create retirement income, then through what we do in life insurance, you're going to create tax-free income. Why wouldn't you do that? Tax-free income. Doesn't make sense to have taxable income when you can have 25% more income. It could be tax-free on top of it, and it doesn't affect any of your other conditions. It doesn't affect your Medicare premium Part B. It doesn't affect your Medicare premium Part D. It doesn't affect the fact of any taxation on your Social Security. All those things, by the way, are impacted by money that comes out of qualified planning. So those are unintended consequences. So if we look at the normal cycle, it's work, earn, spend, borrow, and pay. And then someone comes in and talks to you and says, hey, you know, Carl, what you're missing here is you need to understand how to save. Okay, well, my answer to that person would be, I know how to save. My issue is I don't have anything to save because I work, I earn, I spend, I borrow, and I pay. So there's nothing left to save. So talking to me about saving is really like talking to someone after the horse has left the barn. It's like trying to close the door in a barn, but the horse has already left the stables. So really, the issue becomes, and this is how we work with you on a consultation basis, the issue becomes increasing your income. You're going to create something, you're going to earn more on top of what you earn. That comes back to the three types of income, which we go over with you. But then that additional earning gives you something to actually save, to put into a program and a plan for yourself. That's where it comes from. Now, you still have your borrow and pay cycle because that's just life. But you have taken this additional income and taken it out of the spend cycle. There's no more spend cycle with that additional income. Now, if that additional income grows beyond what you need to do to build your bank and your resource, then yeah, you can take that additional income that's more than what you need, and now you can spend it as well. You can throw it back into the spend, borrow, pay cycle. So these are the things that we will go over with you in a consultation. Okay. So really what we're trying to do here is help you understand that learning is important. What you're going to learn, you're going to learn, as I said, you're going to learn about the three keys to financial independence. You're going to learn about the three types of income. You're going to learn how that you can set these kind of things up for yourself with the help of a financial concierge. We're going to provide you financial transformation that's going to be complimentary. It's going to be inside your Advocacy Network membership, which for having a consultation with me, I will give you an Advocacy Network membership, which is a $395 value. And basically, financial transformation is part of that membership. So you'll have financial literacy education combined with self-development. And then obviously through your financial concierge, you're going to work together to create financial independence. So that's the story in the short and long of it. It starts out very simply by you simply going and getting the book for free. Get the book. I know people don't like to read. I understand that. It's a book that was written. It's very friendly. It's very reader friendly. So you can get the book and just kind of, peruse through it, guide through it, ebook, and pick out the spots you think are important. And then kind of try to tie it all together. But you go to www.theadvocacynetwork, theadvocacynet.com. So theadvocacynet.com is where you'll get the book. And you can download, automatic download. Now, from there, I'd love to follow up with you. I take on one new client a week. Now, the rest of my work is training and coaching financial concierges. We have a network of financial concierges. So yes, I still do client work because I enjoy it. I love what I do. And I want to help educate the masses. But at the same time, we wanted this message to go out further, expansive, so that we got into training and developing financial concierges. So while I only take on one new client a week, that doesn't mean I don't pass people to our well-trained, established, and coached financial concierges who can do the exact same thing I can do because they're coached and trained to do that, okay? Now, at the end of the day, this is about one thing and one thing only. This is about you becoming financially independent. This is about you recognizing and breaking through the barrier of the belief that you can't. Because trust me, the 95.5 is built because most people believe they can't do this, especially middle class. They say to me, oh, Carl, I only earn between $25,000 and $50,000 a year. I don't really have any money. I got no money for anything. I can barely get by in my life expenses. Of course, familiar with that, very familiar with that. Most people are in that, okay? You've got people who then go from the $50,000 to the $150,000 a year realm who got the same problem, okay? Because a lot of times it's not how much you earn, it's how much you're going to spend. And the more you earn, the more you're going to spend. So basically, we're showing people that you can attain these things. However, in order to do it, you're going to have to increase your income. We're going to show you how to do that. We're going to walk you right through that and get that increase in income and then create your own bank, And that's going to create financial independence for you. Then everything else you tack onto that and build onto that is going to come through life as you go. Okay. Once we define what financial independence is to you, once we define what's important to you, what's important about money, what do you believe to be true about money? Once we defined how to reset your mind on being contrarian, and once we show you this device, this beautiful device called life insurance, not what you hear every day and not what you see in the ads, not what you see on social media, that is so far removed from the truth of the value of life insurance. Okay, the life insurance industry has been around 200 years and they have never had a financial failure, economic failure. They've been through the Civil War. They've been through all kinds of World War I, World War II, all of those issues. They were through the 2008 collapse. And if you notice at the end, the thing that was still standing, rising from the ashes like a phoenix, were the life insurance carriers, the life insurance companies. Sure, a few of them got themselves involved in offsetting and banking and all, and they should have never done that. And that caused some pain for them. But the true focused life insurance carrier, they will be here forever and ever. You have a safety net and a tremendous opportunity being inside with a life insurance carrier. And someone like myself, who's professional, been doing it for 44 years, who knows the ins and outs of a life contract and can show you how to maximize all of that for yourself. Believe me, the majority of agents cannot do this. They're not trained, they're not coached, they're not developed. Now, I told you, we coach and train financial concierges, but my phone does not ring off the hook with agents who want to learn and become financial concierges. It's just the opposite. When I try to recruit financial concierges and speak to agents, they fluff me off because they don't have time and they know what they know and they're not aware of what they don't know. They don't know what they don't know, and so they fight it. So they'll give you bad advice on a regular basis. You got to get away from the bad advice. Bad advice in and of itself is financial victimization. And too many people have been financially victimized with bad advice. Some of that bad advice was intentional, and shame on those who did that. Some of that bad advice is just incompetence, okay? There's no control for that. Somebody just spreads speaking points and talking points and just spews out bad advice. And they believe it's good. But it's never good unless you can see the end result. How it ends is what counts. How your story is going to end and how you're going to enjoy it on the way, on the journey, is the real issue. Not where is it starting or beginning or what's happened in the past. It's where it's going from here. All right, well, thank you so much for your time. Please go to theadvocacynet.com, get the book, and if you want to call me direct, you can call me at 321-947-3220. Of course, when you get the book, I will certainly follow up with you. And as I share with you, I take on one new client a week, and that's it. But I definitely will help anybody that wants to learn this system and get themselves going and become financially independent, because it's available for everybody. All right. You just have to take the first step. So have a great day. Thanks for your time. And I look forward to speaking to you real soon. Enjoy that book.